Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I am going to show you how to customize the Blazor Kanban header, swimlane, and card using the template property. Let's start with the coding part. I'll open my existing example, where the Kanban component is configured, to show the work in progress of software development. If you want to learn how to create a basic Blazor WebAssembly app and add a Syncfusion component, please refer to the video linked in the card above or in the description below. Let me run this application now. Look at the output page, the Kanban component is rendered, with the software development work in progress. Also, notice that the swimlane is enabled for Kanban cards. Let me show you how to add an icon to the Kanban header using templates. I first add the template tag inside the Kanban column tag. Then I create implicit context parameter for the Kanban column and store it in a variable column. I add a content division tag, which acts as a wrapper for the column header. Then include the built-in CSS class eHeaderWrap to align the header content. I add span tags to display the icon and header text. To this span element, add the class headerIcon and define a few CSS styles to align the header icon. Then, within this span element, add the header text from the context variable column and include the built-in class eHeaderText to align the header text. Here, I specify the key fields as the class to the span element to show the icon. Next, define a font face CSS rule with a specific source path and name its font family as Kanban Priority Icons to start accessing the required font icons at the application level. Then, to those class names that are assigned to the icon properties, I need to assign the appropriate content values to access the needed font icons. So, add the content property to the classes with key fields like open, in progress, validate, and close. You can refer to the content value for these icons from the documentation link that I have shared in the description part. As you can see, custom icons are added to each column. Now, let me show you how to add an image to the Kanban Swimlane header using the template property. Remove the text field property from the Kanban Swimlane settings tag and add the template tag inside that tag. Then create an implicit context parameter for Swimlane settings model and store it in a variable Swimlane. Next, add a content division tag, which acts as a wrapper for the swimlane header, and include built-in class e-swimlane-header to align its content. Then add an image tag to display the icon. And then specify the path of the images under the root folder. Next, add span tag to display the swimlane text using context parameter, along with the built-in class e-swimlane-text to align it. Under this style tag, I define a few styles to align the image element under Swimlane. Look at Kanban, Swimlane headers are displayed with appropriate images here. Finally, I will show you how to display additional information, like task priority to the Kanban cards using the template. First, add the template tag inside the Kanban card settings tag. Then create an implicit context parameter for Kanban data model and store it in a variable card. Next, add a content division tag, which acts as the wrapper for the card content, and include the built-in class eCardWrapper to align its content. Then add the span element and access the title from the context variable card. To align the header caption inside this span element, include the built-in class eCardHeader. Inside the content division tag, I add the description from the context variable card and include the built-in class eCardContent to align the description. After that, add the task priority from context variable card inside the content division tag and include the class ePriority and define a few CSS styles to align it. Notice here, the newly added content task priority is shown in the card. Let me quickly summarize what we have seen so far. I showed you the ways to customize the Kanban header, swim lane, and card using the template property. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.